Welcome to the show today. We're going to show you how to make some Klingon bloodwine. But we're going to make beer. We're going to make a homebrew. So what we've done is we've taken our juicerator here, and I've put in about 6 large beets. Let me grab a glass here. And we're going to make 3 Klingon Star Trek drinks. The first one we're going to make is going to be Klingon bloodwine. Now, the bloodwine on Star Trek is supposed to be fermented from blood and sugar. But we're, of course, not going to make it out of blood. We're going to make bloodwine out of beets. Beets are also fermentable. And we're going to use some dry malt extract and maybe a little liquid malt extract and some hops, and we're going to turn it into a beer. And then we're going to make Klingon Ratagino, which is that coffee drink that was served at Quark's on Deep Space Nine. But we're going to make that into a coffee beer. And then we're going to make Warnog. You know, the Warnog is the Klingon ale that dates back to the time of Kalis. It's the oldest drink for the Klingons. And so we're going to make Warnog also. And it's going to be like a Dunkelweizen, if you know what that is. We've got 8 cups of beet juice. I got a gallon of water in my kettle here. And we're going to use some Mallard Malt's Golden Extract, 3 pounds, and we may use some Bryce Golden Light as well. I'm going to use some Sod's hops, and I'm going to use some Windsor yeast. So I'm going to ferment it in my black bucket here, so that I ain't got to worry about the beet juice staining anything. It may stain the inside of my spout, but I got plenty of those. So when we come back, my water should be up to temperature, and we'll go ahead and start this Klingon bloodwine. You're going to like this. Okay, I got my gallon of water on, and I'm going to go ahead and add my 8 cups of beet juice, folks. Because those beets have to come up to at least 200 and some degrees. Otherwise, you're going to have issues in a fermenter. We need to convert those sugars, the starch and sugars in them beets as well. Because we're really not worried about the beets being so fermentable. But there's no reason to waste that sugar and starch that's in them beets. So, we're going to utilize the beet too. It'll give the beer a slight flavor that when you tell people it's Klingon bloodwine, they're going to actually think it's Klingon bloodwine. So that beet's going to give it that look. Because first you taste things with your eyes anyway. It's going to give it that look and that flavor that's going to be just slightly different. It's still going to be a beer. It's just going to be a fun beer. So we'll let that come up to about 165, and then we're going to add our malts, our DME and our liquid malt, and then we'll probably add the hops at about a half hour. I don't want it to be too strongly hoppy. And we're going to use some World Flock as well. And we're going to use some yeast nutrient also. So when we come back, this should be up to temperature, and we'll show you the second step. We're not going to strain this wort. When it's ready to cool down, we're not going to strain it. We want that beet pulp and everything in there to give this beer that blood wine color. See, there's chunks of beets in there. I might pull that one out.
I don't want chunks, but I want the macerated, pulverized beet. So it's coming up here now. A couple more minutes. And make sure you sanitize everything. Just because we're making Klingon blood wine, doesn't mean you actually got to be not worry about sanitation. I'm going to do all the Star Trek beers, and we're also going to do Mutter's Milk and Butter Beer. Butter Beer, I think, is from Harry Potter and some other movies. And we're going to do Arcanius Lager, Green Dragon Brew. Now, the Green Dragon Brew is beer that's normally made with cannabis, with marijuana. But we're not going to make Green Dragon Brew with marijuana. We're going to use spinach. So, we're going to use probably some spinach, maybe some other green leafy thing. But we're not going to use, I believe I'm going to do it with spinach. But I'm not going to use cannabis, so we're not going to make the traditional Green Dragon's Brew, which is an actual beer, folks. It's made out of the cannabis. It's made out of the THC, and the THC in that beer, along with the alcohol, gets you extremely high. So we're not going to be making true Green Dragon's Brew. We're going to make our version. So. But, you know, there is recipes out there for Green Dragon's Brew. You know, that's hard to say. But we're going to do that in a couple weeks. We're going to finish these, all the Star Trek, the Romulan Blue Ale. I got to show you how I'm going to make that blue. So we're going to do a bunch of the Star Trek beers first. And then we'll work our way into the other sci-fi beers. Okay, so that's coming up to temperature, and we're going to add our right now we're going to add our liquid malt extract. Oh! Did you see that? The ring came off of that. Ain't that something? Now I got to fish that out of there. Let me sterilize this. Always make sure you have a thing of sterilizer, folks. Can you believe that little ring? I'll never find it. I gotta get the spoon. Alright. Can you believe I didn't take that ring off that? Yeah, I seen it. Seen it. Where is that? I cannot believe. Alright, I'm going to have to put this jug down. Now, again, remember, turn that upside down sterilize that. Turn that upside down in a measuring cup, and you can add it. Now let me find that ring off the jug. I cannot believe that. It's in there, folks. Oh, crap. I have to get a bigger spoon. Well, that ring wasn't sanitized. Something happens, I'll blame it on the ring. There it is. It's all that beet pulp. I don't want to take all that. There's that ring. I can't believe that. I'll know the next time to take that ring off. Okay, now we're going to add our DME. Going to be a really good beer, you'll see. You can't screw up beer, folks. That's my point in all these strange little beer videos. that I make. You can't screw up beer. And I show you what this stuff looks like. It's no joke. Look at that. You're going to see that this is going to come out red. Alright. Oh, that's good. That's going to be good. I should have added probably a few more beets. It's still going to have that red hue. It'll be fine. Oh, we still got about 7 minutes on the boil here. I just want to just show you that there's them hops coming back to the surface. Got my yeast nutrient in there. I'm not adding no maltodextrin this time. So I want that rustic. It doesn't have to be so smooth. Alright, I gotta watch this because I don't want to boil over. There's a lot of starch and sugars in this. See, I can already see it starting, so I'm gonna raise that up. I only got a couple minutes left anyway. I'm gonna turn that burner back. I really gotta watch this close. So I'm just above my mark, about a degree or so. Klingon Bloodwine. You see that red color? You know, you can make a red ale and call it Bloodwine. People go, ooh, ah, really? You can tell them you made it out of lamb's blood or something. Watch them try to throw up. Then after they've done it, you go, I was only kidding. Beets, folks, beets. Beets are fermentable. That's my point again about fermentable items. You know, everybody's doing all these traditional beers, and I'm trying to do something that people ain't seen. Beets. Beets are fermentable. There's a lot of fruits and vegetables that are fermentable. If it's got sugar, if it's got starch, you can ferment with it. You ain't seen anything yet. Alright, we got about 5 minutes left here. I think it's calmed down. It's still at 212, even though I cut the burner back. In fact, it's above my mark a little bit. You see that? Why are your videos so long? Well, because you need to see what's going on so you know what to expect. Okay, I've got my wort chiller going. My timer just went off. Shut my burner off. I'm going to put my strainer right there. We're going to go ahead and dump this wort. Now I got a gallon of water in the bottom. I'm going to dump half in, folks. Let that water chill it a little bit. I don't want to melt my fermenter. And you can see that water's coming out pretty hot. Now I'm going to save this water. I got my containers. I'm going to save this water for the flowers. And I didn't get much out, but you can see I got some of those big chunks out of there. I'm going to throw this in the trash. Check our water. It's cooled down a little bit. Doesn't take but about 12-13 minutes to chill your wort, folks. And we're going to aerate this wort too. Once it drops down below 90 degrees, we'll take our gravity reading and we'll aerate it. Gotta get another container here to catch this water. Not going to waste any of our water. Alright. Okay, we got a lot of that chunks out of there. Now you'll see, when you do pumpkin ales and things like that, you're going to do the same thing. The exact same thing. So, whether it's beets, zucchini, or pumpkin, it's the same principle. Alright, I'm going to go dump some of this water. And it's going to take about 12 minutes to chill this wort down, and we'll be back. Okay, it's only been about 4 minutes. I've only got like a gallon and a half of water, and it's already dropped down to 125. Starting on my second gallon of water. You can see here, got my jugs. Last time I chilled it down and filmed it, I think it was like 20 gallons altogether. This water's pretty cold tonight. It's going pretty quick. It's still probably going to take about 15, 20 gallons. Okay, about 9 or 10 minutes now. And I'm at about 7 gallons of water on my wort chiller. I got it on real low. It's not bad. The water's starting to come out chilled now, so, and my temperature is right at 98. Well, right at 100 now. 101. So we're going to let this get down to 90, and we're going to, about 95 or so, we'll take our gravity reading. Make sure you sterilize your cylinder, especially if you're going to put that back in the wort there. Make sure you sterilize your hydrometer too. A lot of times I just pour it out. I mean, it's only about 4 ounces. Okay, my as you can see, the chiller is starting to get really cold here, so that means that it's chilling down. And it's right about 98 again. So we'll come back in just a couple minutes. Okay, we're down to about 90 degrees. And I done pulled my sample out. And we're going to check the gravity here. Oh, as you can see, look how it's got a slight, it's got a slight red hue to it. Let me grab a flashlight. I got one. Got a little headlamp here. We'll show you. It's got a slight red hue. Should have put a little more beets. It'd have been a little darker red, but it'll come out like a red ale. Let's check its gravity. Gravity was a 1066. So we always come out around that. Hey, if you don't have an aerator, that thing gets down about 90. Just do this. That'll put some aeration in your wort. I mean, I got an aerator I'm going to use about 10 minutes. But you can just do this. And that'll put some aeration if you got a wort chiller. You know, why don't I just do this? And we won't use my little pump. And then we'll tell you how that did. Alright. I got some oxygen in that wort. Okay, so my temperature's right about 80, 85. So we're going to go ahead and pitch this yeast. Let me seal this puppy up. Check on it a couple times in the next 7 days, but it should start fermenting within the next 4 or 5 hours. And I'm not reconstituting this Windsor yeast. Windsor is a hardy, hardy yeast, folks. It's a British style yeast. And we're going to seal it up. Find my lid here that I've already sanitized. Where did my lid go? Let me find my lid. No, it's right there behind it. Now, let me pour some sanitizer back over it again. Made a mess in the kitchen again. Alright. So, we're going to seal this up. And I've never had trouble with this fermenter. Like some people. Now, I got some sanitizer in that airlock. I'm going to put a little bit more. You can use water, you can use sanitizer, whatever you want to put in there. It's not going to get into the beer. Okay, so that's my version. It's just red ale made with beets, but I'm calling it Klingon Bloodwine. Alright, so for Tom's Beer Channel, I'm talking Tom Moore. And come back for part two. Good luck to you. Alright, well, there's my Klingon Bloodwine, my beet beer made out of beets and golden malt extract and golden dry malt extract. A little bit of Saaz hops in there, 1 ounce. There's some wine still going. Look at that. That's the secondary fermentation on the wine. Anyway, this is just an update on that Klingon blood wine. It's not really going to be a wine. It's going to be a beer. It's going to be more of a red ale. But this is after 6 hours. Almost 7 hours. She's going strong. I got some wine over here in a secondary that's already been processed out, so it's getting ready to be racked, that wine here, probably today. Let's see what we got. Got some wine and beer in my little wine fridge. In here I got a keg of wheat beer. I got some amber ales in the bottles. Some blackberry wine. I don't know what I'm doing with that. So that red ale, that Klingon blood wine that I made out of beets, I've got that fermenting. It looks like it's 72. I got a fan blowing the air conditioner in this room, so, so it's fermenting at 72. Okay, it's been about 12 hours on that, beet beer, my AKA Klingon Bloodwine. It's really going, ain't it? Let's hope it keeps that up for the next couple days.